Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. And if it's your first time, I hope you like what you see and subscribe. Time for a review video. But before we do, these are extraordinary times with the COVID-19 outbreak. I just want to take a moment and encourage everyone to take the necessary safety precautions to protect themselves. Stay calm and we'll get through this together. Now, back to the review. So there she is, a 2020 Ford F-150 XLT in the sport trim. The color is Velocity Blue, and one of the first things that some of you might notice is I swapped out the grille with an STX one. Some of the other features up front are the tow hooks, fog lights, engine block heater, and the halogen headlamps. The wheels are 20-inch six-spoke painted aluminum, wrapped with 275/55 R20 Goodyear Wrangler All-Terrain Adventures. These are only a 4-ply, so if you're doing a lot of off-roading, I would strongly encourage a heavier-duty tire. When I did my research on the F-150, a big selling feature for me was the aluminum body and chassis. This reduced the overall weight from about 5,500 pounds to 4,800, with another benefit being no rust. I also undercoated the steel frame at the dealer for about $700 Canadian. Now I know that aluminum is not as strong as steel, but I'm not using this truck for work, so it'll more than suit my needs. This truck's a big vehicle, and this cab is a Super Crew with a 5.5-foot bed, with an overall length of approximately 236 inches. That makes the running boards a nice option to help you get in and out of. The sport trim doesn't have the lift assist tailgate. That's a little disappointing, but it does have the built-in step. To open up your tailgate, simply push the button. Step comes down, telescopic handle out. Just the opposite when you want to close your back up. In she goes. Another option the tailgate comes with is a remote lock, which is kind of nice. The trailer hitch is standard and the truck is pre-wired with a 4- and 7-pin setup. I had a sprayed in liner applied to the bed of the truck just to make it last a little bit longer. I think these are a heck of a lot better option than the plastic inserts. A couple other features here are numerous tie downs and LED lights. A little switch on the side here to activate those. When you do it, it also turns on your rear cabin light. The gas tank has the Easy Fuel capless filler, which brings us back to the cab. I've had previous Fords, and one option that I constantly used was a keyless entry pad. Pretty convenient when you don't have your keys with you or when you want to lock them in the vehicle. The fob that comes with the XLT has a key, an unlock button, and a lock button with an alarm. To activate the remote start, hit the lock button once, 2X button twice. Green light will come on to show that the engine's running. To shut it off, hit the 2X button twice. Red light will activate to let you know that it's off. As you can see, the interior of these vehicles are huge. Mine's a black sport cloth with the 40-40 console split. The driver's seat gives you a commanding view of the road and a real sense of security. I also like the cutaway feature in the door for increased visibility that you really need in these full-size vehicles. The driver's door has your power mirrors and windows, with the front driver and passenger side having the one-touch feature. This is your headlight switch along with your fog lights, rear cabin light. This adjusts the light setting on your instrument cluster. You have your parking brake and your pedal adjustment down here. The instrument cluster is pretty simple with an analog tach and speedometer, along with your basic temperature gauges for your oil, coolant, and transmission, along with your fuel. Steering wheel comes with tilt and is telescoping. Also has your controls for your information system on your dash, your cruise control, adjustments for your entertainment center, and hands-free for your cell phone. 4x4 is controlled from here with the trailer assist just below. The center stack is pretty simple with your traction control, hazards, and automatic start stop buttons up top. This is your 8-inch touchscreen for the Sync 3 system, and Ford also installed Android Auto and Apple CarPlay. I like the large volume and tuning knobs for your media center, and the climate controls are very well laid out and easily accessible. One feature that we really like up here in the Great White North are your heated car seats. The truck's equipped with a rear view camera, and if you hit the plus symbol, it zooms in on your hitch. Another handy piece of technology that the F-150 comes with is the Ford Pass app. I had mine downloaded at the dealership, and it comes with all kinds of convenient options. Some of the ones that I'll probably use the most are the remote start, along with the unlock and lock feature. Getting harder to live without these cell phones every day. Your overhead console has your cabin lights, sunglasses storage, and your controls for your rear power window. The gear shifter controls a 10-speed transmission that has 5 different drive modes, and those are controlled from here. Drive modes include normal, tow haul, snow wet, eco, or sport. The center console has lots of room and USB ports, along with cup holders and massive space for storage. There's plenty of space in the rear seating area, and it will comfortably fit 3 adults. There's also extra USB ports and power outlets, along with some cup holders. The seats also fold up out of the way, providing additional storage space. My F-150 came with a 2.7-liter twin-turbo EcoBoost. Let's start her up and see how she sounds. Not exactly the deep rumble of a V8, but if you're looking for that, pick up the 5-liter. The 2.7-liter produces 325 horsepower and 400 pound-foot of torque. It's matched to a 10-speed transmission, and it has a towing capacity of 7,600 pounds. Combined fuel consumption is 11.8 liters per 100 kilometers, and the payload capacity is 1,700 pounds. Now, Ford touts these as best in class. However, that doesn't really matter much to me, as long as it suits your needs. Now let's take this puppy for a drive. The first thing you'll notice when driving the F-150 is that this thing handles more like a car than a truck. Now, don't get me wrong, the dimensions will quickly remind you that you're in a full-size vehicle, especially when we're talking about the turn-in radius or trying to get into a parking spot. The steering's electric and quite responsive. It does have a little bit of a light feel, but all things considered, it's still pretty sporty and nimble. Zero to 60 times in the 2.7 are a little over 6.5 seconds, and when you hit the gas, this puppy will get up and go. This sure as heck ain't like the old Explorer. There's lots of mid-range wallop in those twin turbos, and the 10-speed transmission makes it a great powertrain. The shifting is smooth, and it drops gears without you even noticing. Something else that Ford has really improved on over the years is the noise reduction in the cabin. I'm at highway speed right now, and as you can tell, it's fairly quiet in here. I haven't had this long, but I gotta say I'm more than impressed. It's no wonder Ford almost sells 1 million of these a year. This is gonna be my daily driver, and it will pull my 2,500-pound boat with ease. Comfort, power, decent gas mileage. Looks like America's favorite truck just became mine. So that's it for today's video. If you enjoyed it, be sure to hit the like button. It really helps out the channel. Until next time, stay safe.